This video is going to be about compound statements and truth tables. So here's what we're talking about. Let's say I've got two statements. Statement P is 2 plus 5 equals 7. And statement Q is 4 squared equals 16. And I want to combine both of these into one compound statement. I want to say 2 plus 5 equals 7 and 4 squared equals 16. So using logic or logic symbols to do this, I'm going to write P, which is the symbol for the first statement that I have here. And then I'm going to write what looks like an upside down V. This is called a conjunction symbol, and we read it as AND. And then I'll write Q, which is the second statement. So now I've got P and Q. I'm combining those two statements together. Now for this statement, this conjunction to be true, both P and Q have to be true. So I can make a truth table to show this. I'm going to make a table. I'll start with the first column, that's for P, another column, that's for Q, and I'll make a third column, that's going to be the conjunction P and Q. Now I can fill these columns in. So I might have a situation where statement P is true and statement Q is true, which means the conjunction P and Q would be true because I have to have both of them true for the conjunction to be true. If statement P happened to be true, but statement Q happened to be false, like if I'd written something like 4 squared equals 7, then that would be false, and the conjunction of P and Q would be false because they wouldn't both be true. So a conjunction of a true and a false is going to be a false. If I had a false statement to begin with, P is false, but Q is true, I still don't have two true statements. They're not both true. So the conjunction is going to be false. And finally, if both statements are false, then the conjunction is going to be false. Now, besides conjunction, I can combine two statements with what's called disjunction. And to do that, I'm going to have the P and then a V, or something that looks like a V, a symbol, and a Q. And this is read as P or Q. In other words, 2 plus 5 equals 7 or 4 squared equals 16. So I'll make a column for that one also, P or Q. Let me fix that Q. Now, for disjunction to be true, all I need is for either one of the parts to be true. They can both be true, that's fine, but they don't have to be. Just one is enough. So if P is true and Q is true, then the disjunction is going to be true. If P is true and Q is false, the disjunction is also true because all I needed was one. If P is false and Q is true, I've still got one, so that disjunction is true. It's only if P is false and Q is false, neither one is true, so my disjunction is false. So this is basically how you go about making a truth table. We could add as many columns as we want. If I want to know something about what happens for not P, I could make a not P column and fill that in. So if P is true, not P is false. P is true, not P is false. When P is false, not P is true. Once again, P is false, not P is true. And then if I wanted the conjunction of not P and Q, I could see what happens when I combine the not P column and the Q column. So when I have not P and Q, I'm starting out with not P being false and Q being true. So the conjunction for that is false. When I have not P being false and Q being false, the conjunction for that is also false. Remember, I need them both to be true. When I have not P is true and Q is true, then the conjunction is true because they're both true. If I have not P is true and Q is false, then I haven't got two of them, so that's false also. And I could keep going on with this if I had an infinitely large piece of paper that would show all the different ways that you can combine P and Q, not P and not Q, variations of it and so on, and find out what the truth is of those combinations. But I think we're going to stop here. Hopefully you've got the idea. And I'll see you next time.